Hi everyone. I hope you're having a wonderful day or a wonderful evening, depending on where in the world you are and when you're watching the video. The absolutely brilliant Mariah Carey sang her song, I Don't Want to Cry Anymore, in Tokyo in 1996. This was released in 1991 on her self-titled debut album. She'd said that she didn't want to sing it anymore, I'm guessing due to the feelings that it created for her. But she did do a performance last year, I've found, so maybe she's performing it again. The song depicts a rocky relationship. And Mariah never fails to impress with her amazing vocal acrobatics and brilliant technique. But let's get into it.
Demo, Samishi, Kyoku desu.
Oh, yes. She also says in the beginning, in Japanese, Totemo sabishi kyoku desu. Kono kyoku wa, I don't want to cry. So this means, this is a very sad song. This song is called I Don't Want to Cry. She did an amazing job speaking Japanese there too. Amazing. Let me rewind it. I'll play it there and I won't stop it.
Demo samishi kyoku desu. Kono kyoku wa, I don't want to cry. Right? Kyoku? I don't know. I'm American, man.
I don't wanna cry, no.
Like I said, Mariah never fails to impress. That is impressive. It's a co-write, this song of hers. So I'm guessing she's written it from personal experience. And you can even hear the impact of I Don't Want to Cry. You can hear the cry in her vocal delivery as well. Wow, what a passionate performance. Oh, full of emotion. Ah, beautiful as always. But let's go through some things that I would like to just point out that I found really, really cool. It was all cool. But these things are so good. She does this change quite often from quite a loud dynamic immediately to a soft dynamic. In music, quite often that's written as FP, forte piano. Go loud, then soft. Here's an example. Baby, I don't want to cry. You'll hear it at that line. Beautifully done. I must find a way of letting go. Cause baby, I don't wanna cry. Wasn't that lovely? Exquisite. I'll play it again. Just helps bring out the emotion of that line in the song. She's an expert storyteller. And another example here. And this is on the word distance. The second half of the word distance, the unce. You'll hear it. Too far apart to bring distance. See, just right at the end, it's subtle, but so super effective. She also sings the first part of distance sort of quite forward. Before that, it's sort of further back and quite deep and with the chest resonance in her chest voice. And then she brings the syllable dist quite forward and ernts, and then ernts is suddenly soft as well. So there's lots to take in there, but let me play it. You'll hear all of that. Too far apart to bring distance. Whoa. Also, she had some beautiful distortion that she used for effect in what we had on the word had. Sort of in there as well, just before it. Too far apart to bring distance. But something keeps us hanging. Oh, well, maybe it was before that. I'll go back a little bit more on the word had. Oh, 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 oh. Too far apart to bring distance. Okay, no, it wasn't there, but there's another one here. It was still nice to listen to that little bit again. So beautiful. Oh, oh, oh. We can make a man promise, but we're still. Again, it's only a tiny, tiny bit on Says of Promises. It's not the best example of distortion, but it's an example where she uses it subtly and so beautifully. That bit again. Oh, oh, oh. We can make a man promise, but we're... Yeah, a little bit of distortion, but perfect. Her breathiness is so beautiful, and it's here. Let's hear it. We're together is breaking me down. Starts on the word break. Oh, let's hear that again. The moment we're together is breaking me down. Yeah, it's beautiful the way she has that breathy tone at times. She uses it a lot when she pulls back to the softer tone, but it's just so beautiful. Talking about beautiful, beautiful tone, just the expressive quality is something that I really love about these two spots. Have a listen. About here. Oh, yeah. All the magic's gone, there's just the shadow of a memory. Beautiful, isn't it? And another example coming up after that. Wanna cry, nothing in the world to take away.
always bad to work with you.
Yeah, just, it's sort of that mid-tone, as in mid-dynamics. It's not loud, not soft, but it's just so nice and expressive in quality. And I can't go past her riffs every single time. They never fail to impress. And there's one coming up here.
To me, and all I'm giving you my heart and soul.
Yeah, again, very subtle. That, beautiful. And there's another one here. There's so many of them. It's like, which one do you pick? There's so many. They're all so good. But which one do you choose at this point? Into that low tone there, and to finish it with that riff. Oh, just, there were two riffs here actually, or might have been three. Beautiful. Oh, there's so much to love. The amazing Mariah Carey. Never fails to impress. I'll just flick this off. Always has a flawless performance. Wow. I hope you enjoyed it. See you on the next video.